Welcome to another Pike and Shot battle. This will be a paired match against Awesome 4. We're at Pavia 1525. So in this match I have the Imperial Army, which did win the battle historically. The French are caught between the garrison and the relief force. The French have some poor quality pikemen. And some better ones, the Lanzknecht Kyle, pretty good troops. Light crossbows, mounted light crossbows. The Argolais are armored, crossbow swordsmen, yeah. Gendarmes, and I believe they must have some Swiss pikemen. Yeah. So the Imperial Army is advantage, so I only win if my losses are less than 32%, so 31% or less casualties. So, garrison, we've got arquebusiers and the colonella. These are mixed infantry units, half pike, and then the rest are arquebus and swordsmen. They are Kyles, but if they drop below, I want to say like 450-ish, they can lose Kyle status, which is pretty brutal. Okay, got heavy guns over here. No line of sight. What is your line of sight? Oh, the wall's blocking it. Okay, fair enough. Hit the pikemen then. So here, we've got our own pikes. And yes, the forest, we should be able to dominate, so I suspect he will simply avoid it. Stradiots are unarmored light lancers, and then we have the Celadas, which are armored light lancers. We might have some Unetes too, which are the traditional javelin-armed light cavalry, but they were rapidly falling out of use this time period after the fall of Granada. Okay. There we are. Next turn. That up. Get ready to cross over. You can just bowl ahead. Okay, and keep moving our foot forward. Could peel off unit crossbows, deny that crossing, which might actually be worth it. Keep our options open. Next turn. Right. Dodge the direct fire. Bat it. Cornella can get ready to storm that position. Okay, otherwise we can wait. Next turn. Okay, well, if they're gonna keep sitting there, I guess we have to keep sitting here. Keep shifting down. Ideally, I want to save my gendarmes for zoning out the useless Kyles, but we'll see if that's actually possible. It's fine. Okay. Next turn. Okay, then we're gonna switch our whole wing to turn march away from contact here until our legs can catch up. Okay, and here we are through. Good. Lock that off. That'll have to do for now. Next turn. Good. All right. Well, not good for much. See if you can help frag that unit. Good. Charge. Apply more pressure. Let's see if we can get a disrupt on the arquebusiers. No. If we shove you, then do we charge and force them to evade? All right, no dice then. Good. Make threatening motions, you sit there, cancel each other out. So it goes. Next turn. Yeah, that's not a surprise. Following them. Get casualties. Fire. Charge. Should be able to follow through with that. More casualties. Damn. Assume. Huh? Damn, they hold firm despite being raw. Alright, fine. Light them up. They hold firm. A waste shooting at them, but not much choice. Good. Let's prepare to attempt to zone out those Swiss. See about it. Here, shove them off. Go for it, why not? He'll get counter charge, etc. Let's slow them down. Damn, stupid priority charge. Shit. Okay. You're off. Go down here. Prepare to confront the Lana slash Kyle. You can also attempt to move to confront the Swiss and zone them out. Totally mismanaged my artillery, as usual. Standard procedure. Alright. Next turn. Lose a couple light cavalry now. This is good. This means we can definitely zone out these Swiss Kyles. Well, this seems like as good an opportunity as any. Yeah, we probably can't frag them actually. Damn. What we can do though is make an attempt at completely ignoring these gendarmes. You're gonna have to take one for the team. Zone, zone. Cover that tile. And we need to consider carefully what to do there. Can we get a drop? Yep. So take care of that. Okay. Continue to light them up. Good. How many units can shoot at the Swiss? What, four? Five? Let's see, one, two, three, four. Okay. Well, keep these horsemen busy. Then opening a lane for the artillery would also be nice though. So here, you go here. Pressure on there as well. Then you go here, fire, and again, and again, and now the cannons. Okay, so you could join the shooting fun as well, or shift around. Yeah, I think we're just gonna enjoy the fun. Turn, and you can start getting ready to go around. Same with you. You being very careful not to block behind these gendarmes. This might get messy. That's okay. Face that way, if they charge and pursue us, maybe we can get a flank. They're zoned out, and we could charge, but there's really no point in doing so. So we need to just slow and steady apply pressure. Awesome Four believes I have it. It's a bit early for that, but it is looking good. Setting that aside. That's fine. Okay, well, first off, go for a break, and they evade. So that's a fail. So it goes. It up. Good. Extra cohesion modifier did the trick. All right, you moving towards the main conflict. Light him up. They're elite, so it's not surprising that they're holding firm, but casualties like that, they can't last forever. Good charge. No, why not? They hold firm. Melee is ongoing. You are in a sticky situation. Why don't you just do that? Could zone out the gendarmes and keep shooting at them. It's a possibility. Here, you away. They hold firm. We can turn because our rear is threatened. We also couldn't really charge here because if we do, then they could rear charge us in turn unless we go. It's a bit. Well, if cheap is the right word. A bit overly mechanical to feel even remotely historical, but that's all right. Know the game, make use of it. Okay, prepare to pile on. Shift over. Shift over. Now, the Swiss might eventually force a disrupt on our gendarmes, so we do have to kind of hurry it up with the firepower. This Coulonnella is going to work its way around. Bit cumbersome. Next turn. That's too bad. We break them, right? Oh, they're in the way. Yeah, I figured charging is better than getting shot at more. Makes sense. And hold firm for now. Anything important? Frag. Excellent. They get pretty raw. Oh shit. Okay, never mind. I will hold the triumphalism for the moment. Okay, this flank is the least encouraging sector, to be honest. If we shove you along, that doesn't really help us that much. So, if we turn. There, then at least they can't pile into our pikemen yet. You shove past, pile in. That could have been horrendous, but it wasn't. Yep. Get out while you can. Need to just hang back on this wing. Kulinella can advance. Can't charge, but we can make movement annoying for them. Impact again. No dice. Fire. Cannons. And keep mowing them down. He's deliberately putting them in my way. But I don't think he can charge there because it's out of control. So, pressure on. And why don't we ignore that situation? More casualties. Okay. Now what? Let's see. Artillery. Great. Good. There's the frag we were looking for. Keep up the pressure on them. Good. And forward. Who's left? Oh, you're fucked. You're just totally boned. Yep. Huh. Great job. Yep, congratulations. Okay. They're zoned, nothing they can really do, and I guess it's not a huge deal. Next turn. Perfect. Well, let's see if we can follow that up before we get disrupted too. Good. Well, let's continue to light them up. See if they break. Get out of the way for us. Good. Okay, now what? Prepare an auto drop against them. Kind of unnecessary. How horrible is that? It's moderately horrible. Let's just press on there. And we could charge, but then you'd turn them for a rear charge, so let's not. Getting that well played. Let's see what happens. Good. So, there we are. Zoned out the Swiss, and the rest pretty much did itself. The mirror is more difficult, of course. So, we'll see how that goes. Good game, Tossum 4, as always. Till next time.